Hey there. Welcome to Life Noggin.
Or is it?
It is.
Or is it?
Back when I first joined the Life Noggin universe, things were kinda cramped. It was basically just me and my friends in a big old room. When I told my animator I needed some space, well, I got all this. And this cool space station, kinda like the ISS in your universe. It's cool and all, but what if you were an astronaut on the ISS and something happened? How could you survive if you were trapped up there? Well, to help figure this out, I brought my friend William Osman with me. He's an engineer, and he's trapped with me.
This was his idea, by the way. I wanted to do a video on cats in outer space without spacesuits. Anyways, to start, let's assume that the comms are down and you can't talk to anyone back on Earth. Nobody's coming to get you, and you can't go back. One of the first things you're gonna need to worry about is power. Thankfully, you've got the sun. The ISS actually gets its power from solar arrays. Made up of thousands of solar cells, these arrays can efficiently convert solar energy into electrical power, typically producing more power than the station needs at one time. When these arrays are in sunlight, around 60% of their generated electricity is used to charge the station's batteries, so that they can keep everything powered up when the ISS is getting some shade.
But if they got messed up, like say it got ripped or bent so that it couldn't get sunlight, you might need to get out there and repair them yourself. Something like this actually happened a while back. After some solar panels were ripped on the ISS, astronauts had to suit up and essentially sew them back together. Oh wow, thanks Grandma Blocko, she's already on it. Now, if you got that fixed, how long could you survive? Well, it would probably depend a lot on how many people you had up there with you. The more people, the more you'll be consuming your resources. The ISS typically has 3 to 6 people on board, with enough supplies to usually last at least a couple of extra months between supply runs. Adjust that to your crew size, and there you go.
Not sure why you brought all your friends then. Because of the supplies, food would probably be the first to go. According to NASA, an astronaut on the ISS uses about 0.83 kilograms of food per meal per day, with about a seventh of that coming from packaging. Cutting calories can make the food last longer, but eventually, you're going to run out. For water, well, that's where the Water Reclamation System, or WRS, comes in. Basically, the WRS takes a bunch of used water sources, like sweat and urine, and purifies them so they can be used again. Am I supposed to drink this? Is this real?
Does it taste like pee?
But it's not just food and water that you'll have to worry about. You're also going to have to worry about breathing. Fortunately enough for you, the ISS has NASA's oxygen generation system and the Russian Electron system to keep you supplied with oxygen. These systems use water to make oxygen in a process called electrolysis, which splits the water into hydrogen and oxygen using an electric current. Together with the WRS, these systems essentially create a loop of oxygen and water that's certainly not perfect, but should last you longer than your food supplies. If this fails, however, you might need to resort to the backup Vika system. Around the size of a spray can, Vikas create oxygen by igniting lithium perchlorate, a solid, oxygen-rich compound. Basically, it's a big candle that gives off oxygen. About enough for a single crew member for one day. In the end, surviving on the ISS would be all about conserving your resources as much as possible. And it's probably better that you didn't have so many people with you, especially the ones that keep eating all the food. We're supposed to be rationing here.
You can't tell me what to do, Blocko. I'm in animation now.
Thanks for watching this episode of Deblocked. Where would you like me to travel to next? Any time period? Any specific place? Let me know down below. Thanks to William Osman for helping me with this episode.
You're welcome.
He makes hilarious engineering videos over on his channel.
What better way to reflect the brilliance of William's channel by making a completely terrible, useless bike?
This is amazing!
Subscribe and tell him he should grow out his beard more.
What? Hey!
As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.